I've tested two Xiaomi phones so far, the Mi 5, which failed miserably, and the Redmi 3 Pro, which survived, but only barely. Today I have a third Xiaomi phone, the Redmi Note 3, and it's time to see what we can expect durability-wise from this device. Accidents happen, and it's better to know beforehand whether your device can survive the next few years at your side. This device is the dual SIM version with the 16-megapixel rear camera. Right off the bat, we notice there is a considerable size difference between the Note 3 and the Redmi 3 Pro. Besides the abnormal amount of sticker residue, the exterior designs of the phone are very similar. The same thickness and the same basic aluminum shell with plastic end caps. Let's start with the scratch test. Already with the pick number 3, we can see that the glass is thin enough to let the pressure leave a design on the IPS LCD, similar to the LG G5. The thinner glass means less protection for the display. The hardness of the glass remains the same though, not scratching until level 6, so that part is still good. The front 5-megapixel camera is protected by the front glass as well, so it is scratch resistant. The speaker grille wiggles around inside of the phone and seems to be free floating, like the old iPhone 4 and 4S speaker grille. The rear panel does look and feel like metal from the outside of the phone. You can hear the sound my razor makes when I scratch the logo. This particular Xiaomi logo is inlaid into the back, just like with the older Nexus 6 phones. Those phones ended up having little bits of plastic logo pop up and out with time, but since the Redmi Note 3's back and logo are both made of metal, I doubt we'll see any issues like that. But at least now we know what to look out for. The regular Redmi 3's logo does not pop off. As suspected, the top and bottom of the phone are made from pure plastic, and the fingerprint scanner is the same type that is on the Redmi 3. And can be scratched. But even a heavy scratching such as this does not affect the functionality of the scanner. My fingerprint can still be set and read by the phone even with the heavy abuse, so no worries there. This camera does have a dual LED flash, bonus points for that. And the rear 16-megapixel camera lens is also made of glass, which is great. It should withstand the basic wear and tear better than a plastic camera lens would. One perk of the Redmi Note 3 over the regular Redmi 3 is that the buttons are made of metal instead of plastic. The average person might not notice, but if you're watching my videos and enjoying yourself, you probably aren't the average person. Time for the fire. This 1080p IPS LCD display lasted 10 seconds before turning black. The screen did recover completely and was cool to the touch within seconds. Still no comparison to the Moto Z's 50-second resilience. But at least it recovered, unlike the Galaxy S7. Some phones are just stronger and more durable than others. So let's start the bin test. As we start the flex, it is immediately reminiscent of the Redmi 3 Pro. With the screen flexing out of the frame, you can see the plastic edge crack on the display. The major difference here is when the Note 3 screen actually comes up and out of the back panel. I was not expecting that to happen, as it seems like common sense to screw all the components together instead of free float them. It is built very similar to the HTC M9, which also failed the bin test. Because of that free-floating, unscrewed, and unattached back cover, the rest of the device is pretty much a goner at this point. Literally, the only thing holding the back cover to the phone is a series of clasps along the edge and that little tiny SIM card tray. So, since now we have the phone open, let's figure out why this phone failed, and why the 30 other phones I've tested did not fail. Remember, I am not saying that this is a bad phone. Durability is just one of the many, many factors people consider when buying a phone. Knowledge is power, and now we know that this phone can be broken, so steps can be taken to prevent it, like putting on a case or not sitting on it. I can see a few flaws that contributed to the demise of this device, the first of which is that there are zero screws holding on the back panel to the midframe, which means that the whole back side of the phone is just a cover instead of a structural component. If Xiaomi added 3 or 4 screws from the back panel into the midframe, the test would have had a very different outcome. Even though the regular Redmi 3 has the same basic design as the Note 3, it survived because it is a smaller phone and has less surface area. Kind of like how a brand new pencil is very easy to snap in half, but a stubby, short pencil is very difficult to snap in half. The Note 3 is larger and therefore weaker. The second thing I notice is that the back panel is mostly made of plastic on the inside. You can see here that the majority of the back covering is just a plastic frame with a thin covering of metal over it. Not near as much metal as you would see on the OnePlus 3, the iPhone 6, or the HTC 10. Those phones were all metal, and all passed the bin test. The last thing is that Xiaomi is using the same brittle aluminum for the midframe that they used on the Mi 5. If the aluminum was just slightly stronger, all of their phones might have survived. Instead, I have three expensive paperweights shedding glass shards all over my desk. So what do you think? Normally phones survive my tests. Should I keep testing the next series of Xiaomi, like the Mi 6, the Redmi Note 4? Or should we play by the three strikes you're out rule and give Xiaomi a break from the carnage? Let me know what you think down in the comments below. My Snapchat followers saw the outcome of this test before the YouTube video was posted, and other behind the scenes stuff can be found on my Twitter and Instagram. Thanks a ton for watching. Hope to see you around.